It was an incredibly beautiful romantic time.
It's simple, great filmmaking.
It's movie magic. That's where it all happens.
The Artist. It's a love story not only for a man and a woman, it's also a love story about motion pictures.
George is the star, you know, came up through vaudeville, a dancer, got a dog act, and he settled into a groove with one character that he plays, some guy with a mask and a top hat who solves crimes and runs around with dames. He is the linchpin star of the studio. His projects brought a lot of money in. He's a really good-looking guy. He's got a ton of personality.
Debbie Miller is an actress who happens to bump into George Valentine at an opening and get her photograph in the trades. Just a little bit of recognition, which gives her the courage to come on and begin to work her way up through the ranks. She has an incredible personality, and she sings, and she's uninhibited.
This girl, Debbie Miller, has got what Eleanor Glenn in the 20s called it.
She has something very spontaneous, a lot of energy. She's always smiling and she's always moving. Her body is always full of life and she's a good person all the way. And I think that's why she's beautiful.
This is right at the advent of sound, and George thinks talking pictures are a joke. He doesn't seem to have any self-doubt, but you can tell the world around him is changing.
George rejects the new technology. He cannot even conceive of it as a way to express himself.
The story is about their two destinies. He's gonna fall and she becomes a huge star.
George Valentin is representative of a lot of actors who found themselves at the pinnacle of their careers in the late 1920s, only to suddenly be faced with obsolescence by the early 1930s.
He's very proud. He's like, no, I don't want to go there. And Pepe falls in love with him and believes in him, and it's a beautiful love story.
Towards the end of the movie, there's this incredible tap number between the two French leads, and it's so beautiful.
So hopeful. And they dance the exuberance of the possibility that their lives are gonna work out.
I love those films. Fred Astaire, Ginger Rogers, Gene Kelly. I mean, this was one of the reasons I wanted to be an actress. I wanted to be part of that experience and be those people. I mean, I can't dance like that, but the beauty of them is they're not even trained professional dancers, and they're incredible.
We studied for 5 months, and the first week it's fun. Shuffle the step, shuffle the step, shuffle the step. Okay. The fifth week it's a little boring, and at the end it's thrilling.
And we knew it was going to be one shot. We didn't want to be cut or, you know, and Michel always said, just smile all the way, look at each
energy,
other,
smile.
Play together, and so people are not going to look at your feet. We were like, okay. It was such a pleasure. I think for the audience to see an actor doing something he's not supposed to know, dance, sing, I don't know, whatever, it's always a pleasure because you can really see the work. That, you know, you don't see the work of an actor, really. But the tap dancing, it's like, oh my God, they did that for 5 months just for us, just for 2 minutes. And yeah.
17 takes.
Yeah, 17 takes.
In your legs.
Movie making can be, and I say can be, an art form and a beautiful one. And I think this movie captures all of that on so many levels, visually, emotionally. I think audiences are in for such an incredible treat.
What's exciting about it is you have a movie using the techniques that were in use in the 20s and 30s to tell a contemporary story to a modern audience, and that's why the picture is as great as it is.
This truly is a great film, whatever era. People will be talking about this film and referencing it in many years to come.